competition and a feeder competition there to the AFL.
You're the truest form of an athlete playing footy. You got to cover long distances, got to be able to have endurance, be quick, athletic, sprint, be strong, and have skill at the same time. And I think that if you fancy yourself an athlete, this is a sport.
Well, everyone plays offense and defense, and everyone is a skilled player. You need to have reasonable endurance, reasonable speed, reasonable strength. There's no restrictions on how tall you need to be. Some guys can be, you know, high 6 feet. Some people are in their 5 foot 5. So it doesn't discriminate against anyone. Anyone can play. The thing that Americans would find particularly exciting about it is the fact that it's so fast paced. The game's continuous. It doesn't stop. The game just continues to keep rolling.
Future of the game, I think that we need to get into more colleges. You look at a team like Minnesota and what they're able to do with college scholarships. You know, kids going over to Australia for a semester and then come back, and they're helping with Minnesota's team. I think that's where our real development's going to come in, and I think we need to really foster the college game.
It's a sport that's really growing, not only in Australia, but all around the world. And there's been a few signings of young American college players in the last few years that have made the transition to our sport and done really well.
So a wide range of ages and fitness levels, and it's really a sport for anybody.
So I looked up Aussie Rules on YouTube, and I thought it was really cool, and that's how I found out about it.
It brings together certain elements from all different sports. Sometimes you might not be the top 1% of a particular sport, but you can use what you know about that sport. And it all is applied very well in Aussie Rules football.
Just check out if there's a club in your local area. And from my own experience, both Aussies and Americans in the club are really welcoming, and they took good care of me. So they'll definitely look out for you, and it's a good time.
Black Chrome Sportswear designs and manufactures custom sportswear with a focus on quality.
Tournament, the 20th edition of the US AFL Nationals, paying tribute to the red, white, and the red, white, and blue in many forms. Okay. My laptop's gone off.
Oh, no. Do you want... I have it on my phone. I have them all on my phone if you want. Hang on.
Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you rise, and out of respect for all three nations, please remove your hats as we begin the playing of the national anthems. First, O Canada. Advance Australia Fair. Thank you. and the Star Spangled Banner. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls and kids of all ages, the United States Australian Football League welcomes you to the 2016 USAFL Men's Division I Grand Final between the Austin Crows and the Golden Gate Roos. I'm Brian Barish. I'm joined by the voice of the Nationals, Grilla. Was that a cheer for me? Probably not. From Stateside Footy. Check.
And the winds are already intense out there, as in it's getting intense and blowing them all over the place.
In fact, it is, and we are just about set to go. The number one team in the nation, the Austin Crows, according to the USAFL Top 20 poll, and the number two team at the end of the season, the Golden Gate Roos. Both teams have gone through this season unscathed, or through this tournament unscathed at 3-0. And gentlemen,
the keys to this game is working out a weakness, I believe, in the Austin Crows armory. And the other thing, though, is not to get too besotted with that. Stick to your game plan. You've come here all season playing your own game plan. Looking at these two, they're very similar sides. I think it's going to get down to even individual brilliance. I think if Owen Gates are going to have a crack at this, it's going to be their big man, Dragas, who's going to have to dominate the match. Of course, Austin Crows have got a couple of big men down there in Cox and Tyrell. If Dragas plays, one of his could be one of the impetuses that might be able to get them across the line. You, Billy?
Last few games, we've seen a whole bunch of congestion around the ground. One of the keys, I would say, is be efficient with your disposals and get the ball down the field efficiently. Try not to get caught up in all the traffic that sometimes happens around the middle of the ground.
All right, as we greet our crowd across the world, around the world on the USAFL.com stream, and the crowd over here in the Cooper's beer tent, let's make some noise.
Come on, let's get it. Hell yeah!
Time, hopefully, but here we go. 40 minutes, the umpire holds the ball aloft, and here we go. Grilla, kick us off.
Well, thank you very much, Brian Barish, from the Besler B Shocker. That great spirit in the sky rises, and it's a good B already. A Golden Gate with their first tap. There's a whistle on the play. Which way the umpire see it go? It's going the way of Golden Gate. They get the first sortie forward. They haven't had problems scoring against the Breeze in their last few matches. And will it be a problem this time? Smashed away there, smash mouth fashion by Austin. Look at the pace, look at the tempo, and away we go. Bounce, bounce, come on, bounce. Let's get the hell out of here. And they're hell raising out there on the wing. Austin, they connect. The number 20 there for the Austin Crows that you can see there is Christou. Christou presses it down to the right half. Forward flank, they rise. The ball skedaddles off back into the zone. In goes Golden Gate. Out comes the ball. The ball's on the wing, but then they connect with the number 9 there, and Kyle Manley Johnson. Whistle on the play. What did you see down there, Bill?
Actually, I
Austin Crows.
Team. Bit of a blow. Is almost on the ground. There again, as they pass it around, does Golden Gate. Clark out of the back. Throws that one onto the right foot. It is marked nicely by the man on Smythe, who goes up over Merritt and finds a connection there in the number 27 in David Marshall. For Golden Gate, they're going to go inside 50. Dragon scoreboard. It is Austin, one straight six, 1 point and only 1 point for the Golden Gate Roos. Austin Crows, one straight six, Golden Gate Roos, 1 point.
47 out of fullback. We'll try the defensive side of the ground, but here's Golden Gate in the van once again. The heavy hitting was caught high. Now pushing the back was called by umpire Steve Hunter. Called to play on now. Trying to sell the Okadote, ran into trouble. Spinorama opens up, didn't miss. Fresh air shot, went to ground, holding the ball prior opportunity. Desperate defense there by Austin. So Austin get a second chance to clear on out. Pledging for a bit of territory, he's got it. Austin, well marked. Down to their left half back attack. The Crows fly, all the arms went up and grabbed there by the Crow, one of their big men, saying, I'm gonna go along, my intentions are we're going to use the breeze. And they set sail, not on the sunset, but down there towards the ridge. Smacked away, defensive side of the ground. Austin in the van. Ball moving at a rapid pace. Another free kick on the play. This time going to Golden Gate there, Bill Roberts.
And once again, Golden Gate moving with the ball, which they did so expertly in their last appearance. And he's just going to hold up right now and just kick a little grubber along the outer boundary. And it looks like that's going to roll out, and that'll be a boundary throw in. So once again, the umpires will put it back up into play here. Black Chrome scoreboard right now, one straight six to one behind one in
looks
favor.
Like things have settled down out there, Bill, after that frenetic start.
Just a bit, and it's coming through right now, and the Crows kick it up back into their end of the ground. Battle for it along, actually not much of a battle, as a couple of players went for it, but then it skipped leftward and went off the ground, went over the boundary line, so it'll be a boundary throw-in, Brian.
Christian Merritt from the USA Revolution, he'll have a chance as he was named as one of the 60 players earlier today, and that is going to be a they're going to look like they're going to do a ball in one more time. In fact, here it comes, spinning into play. The big man rise and came up with nothing but a fistful of air. He throws a nice mark, and he's going to play on as he handballs it back. He gets away, he'll shake it and bake, he'll try it there, he kicks it in right in front, and he's kicked a goal.
That's Grant Cambo.
He is an old veteran of this game. He is a champion man, and that adds to the score of the Austin Crows on the Black Chrome scoreboard. That takes them on to two straight 12, 1 point for Golden Gate.
That's the way it is back in the middle. Austin, well, everyone's got to keep their heads up. It's a long, long way to go. Again, the ball has been caught in the fence or on the ground a few times. We've seen Golden Gate play down the alley to our right in the last match. Is that something that they will employ in this match? What a great match this is. Up again, Austin take ascendancy. They like to tap the ball back, then have a man on the outside, like a Buffalo Boy going around the outside. Caught there, the Golden Gate. Not the Golden Gate, Roo, yes it is. It's riveted to the ground. The umpire comes in and says, I will release you. Please release me, let me go, the ball says. Who loves it the most? Who do you love? We love US football. Again, now here's a push paid away from Austin. So it's going the way of Golden Gates against the big number 13 there for Austin. Golden Gate towards right half for the top. It went, couldn't connect. Ball rolls out of bounds. Brian Barish.
As a boundary throw in on that far sideline, somewhere over there, again on the Black Chrome scoreboard. It is two straight 12 for the Austin Crows, looking for their second championship in a row and their third in 4 years into Division One level. Golden Gate looking for their first Division One championship ever. This is their first grand final since they went back to back in 1998 and 1999 and lost to the Boston Demons. That was a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, and they hope that this will be a new hope for the Golden Gate Roos. And here, in fact, is a new hope. It's a free kick. Look at me make sci-fi references. As that one is kicked, that one will go in deep. It's a one-on-one contest.
Oh.
Nice mark by Sam Nix, the man from Montrose. He goes out to the near side, where he takes nice sliding mark taken by the man in number three. That is Daniel Brown. He's the baddest man in the whole damn town. He throws that one up on the right side, and it looks like, oh, up almost taking the mark. It goes to ground, goes and gets it up. Now they'll throw that one onto the right. Long one in, 15, no, can't get it. It bounces free. Golden Gate trying to get it through and then punched out of there with the fist of a thousand suns is Wes Mitchell. And that one goes off to the side. It will stay in. It'll get nurdled, and it will get nurdled out of bounds. Deliberate, maybe, but no. In fact, it's going out for a throw-in, Bill Robert.
And once again, they set up. Good result for the Roos as they have it at right forward flank. As they get,
he's got a free kick. They've got to step in. And the umpire just chatting to that Austin Crowe there, number 47.
And that's kicked in now, looking for and almost getting it there. And once again, we have a stoppage in play.
Ball's out of bounds.
Goes over. We'll have another good result for the Roos.
Around along. Though instead he's going to go in short. He does. It goes to ground. Nice mark. They're going to play on quickly. Here's the man at number 46, in Tahini, who we've called their third straight goal. They go to three straight 18. 1 point for Golden Gate. Austin taking this game by the throat early.
Yes. Some good usage of the Breeze here by Austin. Breeze won't do it for you. They're using it very well. Grant Campbell, another one of their, a stocky type of forward down there. They've got the big fella there, Cox. But Grant Campbell is one of those guys who's a strong mark for his height. One of those guys that bats above his average, if you will. This is more than average.
Dennis Ryan calls him the Peter Dacos of the USAFL.
Not a bad call by the El Presidente. We're back in the middle, back again. It's never over till it's over. We will not be beaten, they've got to say, Golden Gate. There must come a time where every man must fight when he believes in justice and right. And their game plan could be right. They've just got to get in there and get going to Golden Gate. Smack down out of the center there by Dragas, who could have looked like he might have come back on the ball. Here they go, all fired up. Golden Gate, they want to respond. Maybe the response is out there on the right wing. They're running. Dragas is using his legs, but chopped off of the pass there by the number 8. Let it rip, let it fry, and Dixie Chicks fashion. A minor score. So a minor score, their first blemish. They move to 19 to the Austin Crows. 1 point. Golden Gate, Bill.
And once again, taking the kick from the back goal square right now is the Golden Gate Roos as they look to move it up the ground. And the kick goes out left, and they find a man in the pocket. Going to go along the outside. That is marked as well. So they chain together a couple. Just looking for a slow, methodical movement of the footy right now. Coming through the wing here on the near boundary. And he gets it to the boot, and that goes up. There's a contest for it, and it'll go to ground, and it'll wind up going into Crow's hands. Austin with it once again, and it's going to take a skip, and he's going to be shepherded off the ball. Or, actually, nope, not shepherded. That's a free kick. They call it for a push.
Richard Gates there shoved them off the ball, Bill.
All right, and so Austin's going to have another shot at it. And another shot to extend this lead. Right now they're up by three straight kicks, 19-1 on the Black Chrome scoreboard. As he's getting set, taking the run up now. And he just kicks it towards the sticks. That will go, let's see here. Going in for the, that's a goal. That's a beautiful goal from that angle. Once again, check side, just put it right through those big sticks. And Austin now up to an even bigger lead now. It is 4-1, 25 to 1 behind 1. And once again, as we check the Black Chrome scoreboard.
And Austin running away with this one. Well, they're probably flying away. They don't run very fast. But this Austin Crows team, they looked something special all year. But don't count out Golden Gate by one iota. This Roos team is probably the best I've seen in my 9 years of the USAFL. Brian Barish alongside Bill Robert and the man Grilla here. And we welcome you wherever you're watching this Division I Grand Final. And, of course, a special hello to all the people here in Lakewood Ranch at the Premier Sports Campus, which has done a fantastic job of hosting this year's tournament. Ball to the ground, and we're going to have a whistle, and it's going to be a free kick. It'll go to the man there in number 10, Pete Pettinari, who just gets it away, but here comes Golden Gate back the other way. He's got to pick that up. He does. Handball, whoops, snapped. It was some kung fu fighting, and he knocked that one down, and then behind the play, we have contact without the ball. It'll be a free kick to Golden Gate. So here come the Roos, a little bit of push and shove. They're looking for the man and Zach Taylor. He overcooked the kick, but he got some help. Turned around as Ryan, a little check side. And that one goes out on the full. So it'll be a free kick to Austin, right, literally right in front of our commentary position, Grilla.
Yes, and thanks also to the Sarasota Sports Commission and working in tandem with the Brandon and Area Sports Commission for allowing us to use this fantastic facility. Also, the Embassy Suites, some of the host hotels. Sweet off the boot for Austin, a good spoil by Golden Gate, but deemed to be over the shoulder. So free kick there to Austin. That's the way Steve Arnott saw it.
And the crowd has gone ape-dropping.
Bradley Tahini. Tahini looking to be Houdini out of defence. Heeds the call to defence. Taken by their number 47, the Austin Crows, who is Sean Connell. Connell connects on the outer side with one of these defenders, and suddenly they're on the wing, but not exactly on a prayer at the moment. On their knees at the moment. They may as well be praying their Golden Gate. A hell of a formation there, but the ball somehow squeezed UK squeeze style out and over and out right in front of the interchange bench, Bill Roberts.
And once again, as they bring it back in, players line up and get ready to go. And it comes and grabbed momentarily by Golden Gate as they try and move ahead. But now it's basically anyone's ball as it comes closer to the center of the ground, and it's handballed off. It'll be a free kick going out to Golden Gate, and they kick it now out to the wing, and almost intercept mark there. Nice spoil by the Crows, and that'll just roll, skip, jump right over the line, and that'll be a boundary throw in. But once again, still something the Roos would like to see, because it still gives them a shot at it closer to their attacking goals.
Sam Nix spreading his wings, the Montrose man, Rick Bunkle knows that man, Rod Bunkle, that's it. I knew I'd say if enough names I'd get his name right. Rod Bunkle, Joel is his son. Ball to the ground, and we will have a ball up, tie up situation again. A black chrome scoreboard score check. The lead for Austin.
The umpire.
Black Chrome Sportswear designs and manufactures customs.
Changes the atmosphere. Toss it up. Take it away, Billy. See if you can clear it.
Well, let's see if we can get him a working microphone. We'll be back with us next.